Honorable Madam, Vanakkam.
Switch on your mic, please.
Madam, in this maiden speech of mine, I wish to remember and thank the great Dravidian forefathers, Tandai Periyar, Pereringa Anna, and Dr. Kalinga. But for the self-respect movement spearheaded by them towards the goal of social justice, I would not be here. And I am thankful to our great leader, Talibad M.K. Stalin, who relentlessly pursues the Dravidian ideals and is in the forefront of defending the federal structure of this nation and has achieved a historic victory. And I would like to thank my father and mother and also T.R. Balu sir, who is the leader of the parliamentary board of DMK and other office bearers. Madam, I rise to strongly oppose the Indian Medical Council Amendment Bill 2019 and the National Medical Commission Bill. At the outset, I want to draw the attention of the House to the statement of objects and reasons appended to the amendment bill. It is evident from the same that the previous government also, by this present incumbents, have abandoned or have allowed the National Medical Commission Bill 2017 to lapse. The reason stated being dissolution of Lok Sabha. But the actual reason is obvious. The bill could not be passed in the upper house for want of majority. Madam, this government and the guests to contain the so-called arbitrary actions of the previous Medical Council of India had been running the Medical Council on ad hoc basis through series of presidential promulgations from the year 2016 onwards. These amended bills are just excuses to overcome legal objections. The very spirit of the National Medical Commission is to favor and privatize medical education by removing regulations for starting medical colleges and by having fees regulatory mechanism on 40% of seats of private colleges. These measures are pro-rich and pro-private management and anti-socio-economic groups. Respected Madam, I wish to bring to the notice that this bill undermines the role of state medical councils founded under sovereign state legislative authority. Moreover, the NMC allows only 5 states out of 24 to be represented at a time and on the rotation. Many states ruled by the opposition party government may never find a place in the body. The role of medical universities is sidelined and they have no place in council functioning. The craspathy allowing Ayush practitioners to practice modern medicine is unethical and will legalize quacks. The provision to permit foreign medical graduates to practice freely and by clamping Indian graduates with licentiate exams is atrocious and malafide. Madam, any effort of a government in introducing a law should be an attempt at improving the administrative structure of the country, but unfortunately, this government's main intention seems to undermine the powers of the states. This effort encroaches the state power quite often and causes great damage to the federal structure of this vast nation of multiple linguistic, religious, cultural diversities. One nation, one language, one nation, one religion, one nation, one tax, and one nation, one election are now one nation, one ration card. Are not good signs, madam. Every move by this government is towards creating an unitary state. We want to register our strong protest with regard to this regard. Madam, repeated acts of destroying autonomous institutions has become the very character of this government. The medical education is one of the most vital sector in this country, and any action, even to improve the same, could only be done with taking the stakeholders into confidence. Ruining the important autonomous body, which has produced talented, eminent, prominent doctors of world repute, is not acceptable. The medical fraternity is deeply hurt and agitated. The autonomous medical council should be allowed to be run by a body of eminent doctors democratically elected through a transparent process. The amendment bill seeks to replace medical experts with administrators from other fields, which is thoroughly condemnable. Nomination of administrators from other fields who have no medical expertise is not acceptable, and the move will be stiffly resisted by the doctors' fraternity. Expertise in respective fields should be recognized and encouraged, and this is the primary importance in respect of medical field. Intentional undermining of expertise of medical fraternity, that too when the ministry is headed by a medical doctor, is not fair, sir. Madam, I want to know about the status of Tamil Nadu government's bill unanimously passed by the Legislative Assembly seeking exemption from NEET sent for the presidential acceptance 2 years ago. NEET for Tamil Nadu is thoroughly unwarranted. The nation knows that Tamil Nadu has the largest number of medical colleges and medical seats and 80% of seats of Indian super specialty studies. Tamil Nadu is the top medical tourism destination and we rank among the top in the medical education and the healthcare. Compulsory imposition of NEET is an act against the poorer sections of the society. NEET is nothing but an entrance exam business proliferation effort netting about 12,000 crores. We do not want NEET to kill poor, depressed class that Anitas, who otherwise through the system followed by Tamil Nadu would have made it to the medical college. Madam, I would use this opportunity to plead with the Health Minister for an upgradation of government hospitals at Kallakurchi and Athur in my parliamentary constituency till the government establishes college due for Kallakurchi. So on behalf of our party, DMK, I request the government to withdraw the amendment bills which seeks to undermine the medical fraternity. Finally, I want to conclude with a couplet from the Thirukural written almost 2,000 years ago in Tamil by the great I.N. Thiruvalluvar. Idipparai illa yamara mannan, edupar ilanum kedum, which roughly translates to the ruler who is not